Well, students, in the previous lecture, we had talked about the Einstein's theory of stimulated emission, in which we obtained two conditions necessary for light amplification. One of the conditions among them was for light to be amplified, N2 must be greater than N1. That is, there should be more atoms in the upper level than in the lower level. And this condition is called as population inversion. Now, let us understand what is the meaning of this population inversion in more details. So, to understand population inversion, first we will talk about what is meant by normal state. So, based on that understanding of a normal state, then we will define what is meant by population inversion. Now, according to the Boltzmann distribution function, which basically tells us how many atoms are there in the upper level, how many atoms are there in the lower level. So that is what the Boltzmann distribution function tells us, and the function is given as N2 by N1 is equal to e raised to minus of E2 minus E1 upon KT. Now, what is N2, what is N1? It is the N2 is the number of atoms in the upper level, N1 is the number of atoms in the lower level. So basically N2 by N1 is called as a ratio of populations in the upper and lower levels. What is the meaning of population? Number of atoms in a given level is called as the population of that level. So the population of the upper level E2 is N2. Similarly, the population of the lower level is N1. So Boltzmann distribution function basically gives us the ratio of the populations of the upper and lower energy levels. Now, this is in this formula, E2 is upper energy level, E1 is the lower energy level, K is the Boltzmann constant, which has a value 1.38 into 10 raised to power minus 23. And T is the temperature in Kelvin scale. Okay, T is the temperature in Kelvin scale. Now, according to this Boltzmann distribution function, who among this is greater? Is N2 greater than N1 or N1 greater than N2? So, in under normal circumstances, at any given temperature T, according to Boltzmann distribution function, which population is greater? The population of the upper level or the population of the lower level? Now, to understand that, we'll have to analyze the right-hand side of this formula, e raised to minus of E2 minus E1 upon KT. Now, if this factor, e raised to minus of E2 minus E1 upon KT, is less than 1, it will imply that N2 is less than N1. If this factor is greater than 1, it will imply that N2 is greater than N1. So, let's check whether this factor here, e raised to minus of E2 minus E1 upon KT, is greater than 1 or less than 1. Now, so this is the formula. Now, e raised to this thing, e raised to minus of E2 minus E1 upon KT, can be written as e raised to minus of x, where x is this term here, E2 minus E1 upon KT. Now, you must be knowing that e raised to minus of x can be written as 1 upon e raised to x. And since e raised to x is a number greater than 1, 1 upon e raised to x will be a number less than 1. So, in other words, e raised to minus x will be less than 1, provided x here is positive. X has to be positive for this thing to hold. If x itself is negative, then minus and the minus of the x will make it as e raised to x, positive x, positive number. And then it cannot be written in this form. And in that case, then e raised to minus x will be greater than 1. So if e raised to minus of x is less than 1, will happen only when x is positive. So now let's check this factor x here. E2 minus E1 upon KT is the factor x. Now, since E2 is upper level and E1 is the lower level, E2 minus E1 is positive. So, because E2 is greater than E1. Similarly, K is a positive constant and T is a temperature in Kelvin scale. In the Kelvin scale, the temperature is always positive. The minimum possible temperature in the Kelvin scale is 0 Kelvin. There cannot be negative temperatures in the Kelvin scale. So, T also is positive. So, all these factors, E2 minus E1, K and T are positive. As a result, this factor X is positive. And hence, e raised to minus of X, e raised to minus of this thing, can be written as 1 upon e raised to that factor, which is less than 1. So, in other words, under normal circumstances, as per the Boltzmann distribution function, N2 by N1, is less than 1. Okay, is less than 1. So, in other words, N2 is less than N1. So, under normal circumstances, which energy level will be more populated? the lower level. So that is by nature we know atoms try to always attain the lower energy state. So if you don't supply any energy under normal circumstances at any given temperature T, there will be always be more atoms in the level E1 than in the level E2, which is shown in this figure, normal population. So this state is called a normal population state, wherein N1 is greater than N2 here, as given by the Boltzmann distribution function. So you can see here there are more atoms in the lower level and less atoms in the upper level. Now, what is population inversion? A situation wherein the population of the atoms in the upper level is more than that in the lower level. That is, N2 is greater than N1. Number of atoms here are more than the number of atoms in the lower level. This situation is called as population inversion. Now, why is it called as population inversion? If you look at this diagram here, this is the diagram of normal population. More atoms in E1, less atoms in E2. Now, if you invert this figure, if you invert this normal population state, if you flip it over, this will go up, this will come down. So, if you invert it, you get this figure, population inversion figure. So, that's why this state wherein more atoms are up and less atoms are down is called as an inverted population state, because compared to the normal population, this is an inverted population. More up, less down. Now, important question here is that why is population inversion necessary for light amplification? It is an essential condition for light to be amplified. Light will never be amplified, laser will never occur without you achieving a state of population inversion, without you achieving a state wherein there are more atoms in the upper level than in the lower level. Now, why is it necessary? Because who says that this is necessary? It is as per the Einstein's theory. We have seen in Einstein's theory earlier that the second condition this requires that if light is to be amplified, if number of stimulated emissions are to be more than number of absorptions, then N2 must be greater than N1. If N2 is less than N1, what will it imply? That NST is less than NAB. In other words, there are less stimulated emissions compared to absorptions. So when there are less stimulated emissions compared to absorptions, light cannot be amplified, because if absorptions are more, then we have seen already earlier that when absorptions take place, photons are taken up, photons are absorbed, photons become less. So that light will not be amplified if absorptions are more than stimulated emission. So light will be amplified only when stimulated emission is more than absorption. That will happen only when N2 is greater than N1, which is population inversion. So as a result, as per the Einstein's theory, light will be amplified, that is stimulated emissions will be more than absorptions only when N2 is greater than N1. If the other way around takes place, if N1 is greater than N2, there will be more absorptions than stimulated emissions, and the medium will absorb the incident radiation and not amplify it. So therefore, population inversion is absolutely necessary for light to be amplified. Thank you.